Hi, this is Kabir Khan, and I'm going to talk about some of the films that had a great impact on me. So these are not necessarily films that I will now look back and say maybe, you know, they're a list of the great films that I've seen. But these are films that at that particular point in time of my life, they made a huge impact on me. And that's the reason why I remember them till this day. So of course, I'm going to begin with the first film that I ever walked into a theater for with my mom and saw it, and that was a film called Bobby. So I will never forget that. I don't think I remember much about the film, but I just remember the visual of me going in this dark, big room with hundreds of chairs and then finding a seat and sitting down and eating popcorn and seeing this giant screen come alive with the visuals. I mean, that will always be a very, very special memory. Of course, it's a beautiful film, Raj Kapoor's film. So we all, of course, remember Bobby. But for me, it always holds a special place in my heart. My mother was a big film buff, and we used to see, I think, every Amitabh Bachchan film on the day of its release, or at least within a day or two of its release. So Mr. Bachchan's films always had a big influence on me. One that I remember distinctly as a child watching it twice, which is very rare. I mean, we would never really actually go as kids to watch a film twice, but this is a film that I watched once with my mother, and then some cousins were visiting and I went back to see it, which is Amar Akbar Anthony. That is a film that, you know, I always sort of remember very fondly. Manmohan Desai anyway was a big sort of influence while we were growing up watching mainstream cinema. Even today, I think in some way or the other, we always pay an ode to him in some of our films. He had this knack of taking these great cinematic liberties and great leaps, but always making them look convincing. And that's something whenever I in mainstream cinema have to make a big leap, you know, it's a Manmohan Desai moment for me. In fact, a lot of people say that the moment where Munni in Bajrangi Bhaijaan starts, gets a voice back and starts speaking, they say that's your Manmohan Desai moment in Bajrangi, which, yeah, I'm more than happy to acknowledge. Then there are certain films which, you know, growing up as a kid, I used to watch only films with fighting, because in those days anyway, Mr. Bachchan's films were all, you know, about the angry young man, so there's always these nice good fist fights, and I would only watch films and I would ask people, is there fighting hogi? And as I said, fighting nahi, I said, mujhe nahi dekhni, bahut boring hogi. And I remember I was in Hyderabad with a cousin of mine, and he said, let's go in a film, go watch a film called Chashme Baddur. And I saw the poster and I said, yes, Farooq Sheikh, and doesn't look like fighting. I said, does it have fighting? He said, no, this hero doesn't do any fighting. I said, I refuse to go with this film. He said, trust me, come and watch this film, you'll enjoy it. And I remember going into Chashme Baddur and coming out of the film saying, oh my God, this was such a beautiful film, and didn't need to have fighting in it. So I think that's when I realized that, okay, you don't have to have violence and action in a film for a film to be beautiful and engaging and entertaining. Then another film that I'd really like to mention, which is actually not, technically, it's not part of Hindi film industry, but I'd like to mention it because it did have a great impact on, I think, all of us in India, and it had a huge impact on me because I also have a personal story attached to it, is a film called Gandhi, Attenborough's Gandhi. So my father was a nominated member of parliament, and we used to live in an area called Pandara Park in New Delhi, which is very close to India Gate and, you know, Lutyens Delhi. And I was cycling with my friends, and I suddenly saw these truckloads of people getting off on the India Gate lawns, and thousands of people getting off. And I was very curious. I went cycling in. I said, what's happening here? And they said, there's a film being shot, and this is Gandhiji's funeral scene. And all these guys are extras. And that was the first time for me. I think even since then, I've never seen such a large number of people in even the biggest of our films. There were just thousands of people coming there, and they were all supposed to be extras in that film. And I said, even I want to be part of that crowd, and I want to be an extra. But I was wearing a red t-shirt, and they said, nahi, well, you can't wear a red t-shirt and jeans. You have to be dressed in a certain way to be part of this scene. So I remember cycling back to my house, putting on a kurta pajama that I had, and came cycling back to India Gate lawns, put my cycle and locked it to the tree, and went into the crowds. So somewhere in that shot, when you see in the opening of Gandhi, where you see these thousands of people walking down Rajpath, I'm sure I'm somewhere there. Unfortunately, the resolution of that camera, I don't think would have caught me. And because I was involved in that, when Gandhi, the film came out, I of course went to watch it. It's a film that completely blew me away. Even today, I think each scene that I watch in Gandhi is a treat. It's a masterclass in how to make a film. It's the first film for which I bought actually an album of its background score, because Gandhi, of course, didn't have lip sync songs like most of our Hindi films, right? But it's an LP I bought, and then I remember hearing all those background score and remembering the scenes they were used in, and that's the first film that made me realize about the power of a background score and how background score can actually completely transform you into a different zone emotionally. So yeah, Gandhi is definitely a film that for me that was very important. And then of course, another film, huge impact, big cliche, I know, because everybody in my generation will say the same name, but it has to be mentioned, is Sholay. Again, a film that was just pure joy to watch. All 3.5 hours of Sholay, each scene, you can watch, it's one of those films that you can take out one scene from the film, randomly, from any place in the screenplay, and watch it as a scene and enjoy it. Take any one character and just watch that character and enjoy it. It's unbelievable. Every character comes together into that film. Every character takes that film one step further. Every scene in the screenplay takes the film further and makes it more enjoyable. So Sholay has to be, not only for its scale, not only for the sheer joy of the acting of Mr. Bachchan, of Dharmender, of Hema Malini, Amjad Khan. I mean, you can go on and on. It's one of those films where I think every actor involved had that career-defining character. So for life, they became the characters they played in Sholay, right? Of course, apart from Jay and Veeru, Gabbar became Gabbar for life. Samba was Samba for life. Angrezo ke zamane ka jailer, Aswani could never sort of get out of that. So every single character was a career-defining character. I don't think you can say that about too many films. So these were the films that had a huge impact on me while I was growing up. This is, of course, I'm talking about films way before I joined film school. And then, of course, when you join film school, you watch many more films. You watch films from world cinema, you watch the great masters. But none really stay etched in your mind the way these films do. When you're growing up as a kid and you watch these films and the films have this great impact on you, that for me is magic of cinema. They'll stay with me for life. Hi, this is Kabir Khan. If you like this video, please subscribe to Film Companion.